I got some candy kisses for your lips. Yes, I got some honey, several chocolate dripping kisses full of love for you. Yes, I got some candy kisses for your lips. Yes, I got some honey, several chocolate dripping kisses full of love for you. My life has been waiting for your love. My arms have been waiting for your love to arrive. My heart has been waiting, my soul anticipating your love, love, love.
From 41 Seaver Way, welcome to the home of the New York Mets. This is Citi Field. The show presents the National League Division Series. The Atlanta Braves going up against the New York Mets. John Ciambi alongside Chris Singleton. A big game two in store for us here today, Chris.
Yeah, this might be the game to actually decide the series move. When it's five games, getting a 2-0 lead is a dominant position to be in, and I don't see this series getting to a fifth game if we have a repeat of game one's outcome in this one.
Yeah, the Crows start circling for a team that falls into a two-game deficit. Not where you want to be. We'll be back to get this one started after this. Just about ready to roll here. And today on the hill, Drew Rasmussen. What do you have on him, Siggy?
Power pitcher. He's going to speed you up with the fastball velocity, and out of his hand will explode the breaking ball. Very difficult for hitters to keep that front side closed and hit the ball the other way because they know if they're not ready to pull the trigger. The fastball will beat them.
And the batter now, Michael Harris. Up the middle. Whips it to first. One out in the top of the first. Here's the Atlanta Braves lineup. Chris, this is a lineup offensively that could be really good for years to come.
They're deep, first and foremost, but the way that they can manipulate their personnel for matchups and everything else, it's very intelligent the way that they use their team. And I think it creates a little bit of uncertainty for opposing teams, especially in a big game, big series.
Jared Kelnick, batting with one down, takes a strike. One out, base is empty. Inside corner at the knees for a strike.
Well, coming off of a blowout loss in the previous game, this lineup can't try to do too much. They've just got to stay within themselves, take each pitch, each at bat, one by one, and try to push runs across as often as possible.
And now one and one two. Straighten him up a little bit. Struck him out looking.
You can argue if there's a hitter, that pitch was dotted on the inside corner of the plate. I think even if he swings the bat, it blows him up and not really able to do anything with it anyhow. I think if you see that early, then perhaps you can pull those hands a little bit tighter and get the fat part of the bat to it. But I'd say overall, you just have to tip your cap on that one. Great execution.
And he deals. And it's even up.
For whatever reasons, this is a hitter that performs better in night games. We'll see what he brings in this one.
Next offering in there for a strike. Now one and two. Two outs. Fouls it off. Still one and two. And the righty deals. Bounced up the middle. Jimenez. The throw to first. And it's a 1-2-3 inning. We're midway in inning number one. No score. Back here at Citi Field. And on the mound today, Bryce Elder. What do we have on him?
Try to stay back for that power changeup. Speed differential between the fastball and the changeup is huge. Hitters, they have a hard time staying back.
We go to the bottom of the first. And stepping in for New York, Andrés Giménez. Line of the pitch. Swing and a miss. Strike one. Elder, a former All-Star, He features a sinker, a slider, a changeup, and he works in a four-seamer. And he'll one. To the right side, Albies tosses to first. One up, one down. Let's take a peek at the Mets lineup here. The challenge for him today, Singy, elevating the baseball against this sinker baller that's on the mound.
Yeah, that's the challenge, but it also might affect the way they approach base running in this one, Boog. You get a runner on first, you anticipate trajectory down, and when the ball's in the dirt with a good secondary lead, you break for second. So whether it's a stolen base or not, you stay out of the double play, get that runner in a scoring position, and that can help you put more runs on the board.
B.I.D., ball in dirt. One down, base is empty. And it's fouled away. Swing and a miss as he chases that one darting out of the zone. Righty delivers. Slider misses outside. Caught and missed. Struck him out. Now two out. Two outs, bases empty. Here's Brandon Nimmo. That one misses. Ball one. Two outs, bases empty. Sharp grounder. That's through for base hit.
Man, those are the types of hits where you don't feel any vibration in your hands whatsoever. Such a good feeling. He wasn't able to elevate it, but he put a great swing on it. Right on time, good balanced approach, and just blasted it through the infield.
Yandy Diaz now. That one ripped. That's back there. And that one is off the batter's eye. Wow, out of here. And they add a pair. It's 2-0.
His plan was to hit the ball hard, and he was going to figure out the rest later. You can't argue with those results. Pitchers typically don't get away with making a mistake like that. And right there, he made him pay.
So two down, Jorge Soler up at the plate. There's a swing and a drive. And that one is off the wall. Around first and hustling for second. The relay, and he's out. Cut down, and that ends the inning. Second inning set to go. Matt Olson up to the plate. He's a guy who does it all. With the lack of contact in today's game, this guy hits for contact, so he delivers average, but there's on-base and slugging too. Rasmussen back to work. And a foul ball.
Early in the count, you have to be real careful because of that power, but then if this hitter gets a strike or two on him, he's still very confident because he has the ability to get the barrel to the baseball. He's a threat deep into the count as well.
Gets a piece, and it stays 0-2. And a pitch.
One ball. He's great.
Swing and a miss. Struck him out, and there's one down.
Velocity, an elevated fastball, even if it's still in the strike zone, can be tough for hitters to get on top of.
Here's Austin Riley.
One wonderful thing about the postseason, you never know who's going to be the hero. Okay. It could be the superstar, but often it's a far more unlikely player.
One down, base is empty. You know, one unlikely postseason hero I saw up close, Alex Gonzalez of the Marlins in the 2003 World Series. Wasn't really known for his bat, but he hit a walk-off homer in extra innings in Game 4. It tied the series and was a huge momentum swing. Lindor on to first. Two up, two down in the top of the second. Two outs, base is empty. Here is Ozzie Albies up to hit. And there's the strike.
Looks like a really good fastball today. You can hear that catcher's mitt popping. Looking forward to hearing a lot of that one in this one.
The Braves trailing by two here in Game 2. Nimmo has it sized up. And that'll do it. Second down, here is Francisco Lindor. And a pitch. Hit hard, base hit. And the leadoff man aboard.
Didn't take long to get a result for that at bat. Anytime you rip a line drive the other way, you feel really good about what you did at the plate. You trusted your hands, you let the ball travel, and you took the barrel straight to it. That's great work right there.
Check on the runner, Lindor back in standing. Lindor the move. Catches low.
Settle in, and he took off right away. Nice job of stealing second right there.
Runner at scoring. Nobody out here in Game 2 of the NLDS. On the ground, right side. That's one out the bottom of the second.
That's a good piece of hitting right there. It's early, but you still want to move the runner up and give your team a chance to score. That's exactly what happened, so you better believe your teammates are happy with you after that at bat.
Foul ball there. Oh, and two now. Swings and misses, struck him out. Francisco Alvarez up now for the Mets. Outfield playing very deep, not wanting anything over their heads. And the first offering is not close. Two outs. Fought off foul. The 1-1. And that one fouled off. Here's a 1-2. hacks and misses. It's a strikeout. Mets strand one, but they hold a 2-0 lead. The third inning, and now it's going to be Adam Duvall.
Adam Duvall,
a former Gold Glove winner, 35 years old. He joined the team as a free agent. Flashes the leather on the running catch, and there's one down. Here's Sean Murphy. This is a guy who is very highly regarded defensively. Fun to watch him control stuff behind the plate. Good game caller, good at framing, but it's that big arm that really stands out. This to third, and he picks it up in foul territory. That one's in there, and the count is 0-2.
You come into the game knowing that unless the ball's in the dirt or gets by him, we're probably not going to steal anything today. So that's where you want to get a little more aggressive on your secondary lead and hope that some base hits, some slugs, some home runs can come into play.
Swings, throw it, and that's a strikeout.
He's really good hitting the baseball the other way, so credit the pitcher for having him out in front of that pitch. Clearly, he had a full roll.
Two outs, base is empty, and the batter will be the shortstop, Orlando Arcia. That one is absolutely belted. And in one hops the wall, makes the turn and heads for second. And he'll make it safely. That's a double.
Up next, nice line drive to the pole side, met it out front, but just stayed through it nice enough and ripped it into the outfield.
So the lineup flips over, and next for Atlanta, Michael Harris. In the air, left field. Nimmo makes the catch, inning over. One left for Atlanta, and they're down 2-0. And welcome back to the ballpark. And here is Andrés Giménez. Here comes a pitch. And first offering is fouled off. Pitch. Ball. And there's a ball.
1-1.
On the ground, right side. And it finds its way through for a hit. So a runner aboard to start the inning.
Just one of those seen-eye base hits through the infield. It just kind of rolled over on it a little bit, but sometimes those can find a hole and get you a knock. And now they've got some speed on first, so we'll see if they try to get him into motion.
Here's Lane Thomas. He's 0-1. Here's the pitch. Runner on the goal. And it's through for a hit. Lead runner around second. Caught in a rundown now, and they tag him out. For the Mets, Brandon Nimmo. 1-for-1 with a single and a run scored so far. That one fouled off.
Really slowed the game down, and it's like he's moving in full speed and everybody is a step or two behind. The way that he squared up that baseball tells me that he is seeing it like a beach ball.
Yandy Diaz up now for the Mets. He's already homered in this game. Swing and a miss. It's 0-1.
One strike.
One run across in the frame so far here in the last half of the third. At the belt and fires. Knocks that one away, and we'll do it again. Kicks and deals. Got him swinging. Slider got him for strike three.
Nice. Doubled up with the slider for that punch out. The one before just caught the zone. So as a hitter, you have to protect right there. Great pitch to just expand a little bit more. He got that chase he was looking for. That right there is good pitching.
And at first, Jorge Soler up now for the Mets. He has, as they like to say,
let me guess, Boo, light tower power.
That's right. Wouldn't chase that time. Nimmo off of first with two away. Pitch. So a foul ball makes it 1-2. The pitch. That's off the mark, and the count is 2-2. Swings and blasts one deep to left center. Out of here. Fire up the dugout. His second home run of the series. It's 5-0. Chris, he's homered in back-to-back games now.
Yep, seeing the ball well, and he's got his timing locked in. He's looking pretty dangerous at the dish right now. Pitch recognition early. He saw exactly where that was going to be. The challenge, not get over anxious and come out of your swing. He stayed on it and got all of it.
So two away with nobody on. Now up to hit Francisco Lindor. And first offering is fouled off.
With how good these offenses are, there's a lot of ball game left.
The pitch. The shortstop takes the ball.
Clearly, he hasn't had it in this game, and looks like sooner than later, they're going to have to go to the bullpen.
Hit hard on the ground to short. Jump throw across his body, and he's safe at first.
Well, that's one of those where you just have to tip your cap because he couldn't have played that one any better. Stood no chance with the speed running down the line.
Runner at first with two away. Key Brian Hayes will hit next. He's 0 for 1. Runner on the move. Into center. Harris sizing this one up. Squeezes it. And that is the third out of the inning. But they strike for three in the inning. Two on this two-run home run. And the lead is now 5-0. We're in the second game of this division series. Now the left fielder, Jared Kelnick. The right-hander back to work. Fastball for a strike. 1-1.
Love it here at Citi Field. You know, it replaced old Shea Stadium back in 2009, and Chipper Jones was really sad to see it go. It's actually the third home of the Mets since they started out at the Polo Grounds for two seasons before Shea was finished.
Swings and misses on the fastball up in the zone for the strikeout.
Well, there's a three-pitch strikeout. He can do whatever he wants with the baseball right now.
And now it's Ronald Acuña Jr. grounded out his first time. That one's in there, going one.
2023 was a special season for Ronald Acuña Jr., the unanimous MVP in the National League. After putting together the first ever 40-70 season in baseball history, safe to say he's going to be a special player for a long time.
And a pop-up, right side, foul territory. And it makes the grab. That's out number two.
That was a good, hard fastball with some nice ride up in the zone right there. Hitter looked like he he was on it, but I think that velocity at the end just beat him. Instead of a line drive or something hit deep, it's a pop up and an easy out for the defense.
Olson at the plate for the second time as he takes ball one. The Mets leading by five, top half of inning number four. Rolls across the diamond, and Olson is set down. And it's a 1-2-3 inning for the Braves. Three up, three down that time. We're midway in the fourth. It's the Mets five and the Braves nothing. Back here in Queens, John Chavi and Chris Singleton with you. And leading off the bottom of the fourth, DJ Stewart. Elder back to work. And he hits a ground ball right side. Throw on to Olson. And one gone to the fourth as they get the leadoff man.
I got a fun fact for you, Boone. You know that home run apple out in center field isn't the old one from Shea Stadium. That's outside of Citi Field now at Mets Plaza. This one is more than four times as large as the old one.
And now Francisco Alvarez. He was a strikeout victim his first time. Ground ball, Austin Riley. Over to first. Already two gone here in the home fourth.
Now back. Second baseman.
So the batting order turns over. Here's Andrés Giménez. One for two. Big swing and a miss.
This guy's got such a good sinker. As a hitter, you've got to look up in the zone. If you look down, you're going to be chasing stuff in the dirt.
Hammered on the line to the left, base hit. Joey gets on base and keeps it going.
A couple of hits in a row for him now here. Pitch was away, and he did exactly what you're supposed to do with it. Drive it the other way. Just go with the pitch.
Stepping in, Lane Thomas. First offering. Runner goes. Line drive, and that should be extra bases. Giménez around third. He'll score easily, and it's now a six-run lead.
Just so sound in his mechanics. Hits against a firm front side, and the hands just continue to carry through the middle of the field.
Manager out of the dugout now, and it looks like we'll see a change on the mound. Bryce Elder departs, and as he heads for the dugout, we'll take a quick break. New arm on the mound when we get back. Ronaldo Lopez takes over on the mound.
And he's had 3 days off since he pitched last, so expect him to be totally rested. I'm sure he's itching for this opportunity right now.
Here's the left fielder, Brandon Nimmo.
RBI knock for him last time. Now a chance to drive in another run.
A swing and a miss, and that's strike one. Man on second, two down. That one not close. One ball, one strike. The Braves bullpen has some activity. Pierce Johnson getting ready to come in for manager Brian Snitker. Right-handed reliever. And a foul ball. Thomas stands at second with two gone. Next pitch is outside. Swings through that one. It's a strikeout. They get a run on two hits, no errors, and a man left. We played four. It's the Mets six and the Braves nothing. Ready now for the fifth inning. Here's the third baseman, Austin Riley. And the pitch.
Well, every pitcher wants run support, and having a lead is nice, but it can be challenging for some pitchers. I think keeping the mindset to attack instead of trying to be too fine and have too much finesse, go after hitters and get quick outs.
And that one is lifted in the air. Thomas makes the grab. What a way. They've got a potent lineup. And when you think about teams capable of rallying from this kind of deficit, they're right at the top of the list. Ozzie Albies up to the plate. Fly to left his first time. He swings and fouls one off. The Braves with a lot of ground to make up. And we're at the top of the fifth. On the ground to third. Throws to first in time. And Albies is retired.
Well, he's doing a nice job of keeping the ball out of the air. Lets the defense work behind him with another ground ball. Good execution.
Two outs, bases empty. Adam Duvall digs in now. 0 for 1 with a fly out to center. And first offering is fouled off. Two down, nobody on. Foul ball.
Now this offense has just been locked down. Almost five full innings of shutout baseball.
Gonna count 1-2. And a swing and a miss down on strikes. And a nice inning of work there as he sets him down 1-2-3. And the Braves go down quietly. They still find themselves down 6-0. Bottom of the inning, and now the first baseman, Yandy Diaz. And a pitch. And first offering is fouled off.
Well, these Mets putting together some really good at-bats in this game. There's been a lot to like with how they're approaching their chances at the plate. It looked to me like they really wanted to get to the starter early, get him out of the game before he settles in, so I'd say mission accomplished.
Swings through that one for strike two.
1-2.
Lopez gets the swing and the miss. And the leadoff man set down in their half of the fifth.
Well, that slider down and away, it's just kind of a slow gap. With two strikes, you're looking to protect. And halfway to the plate, you know you've committed. And you know you're going to have no chance of touching it. Tell you what, sometimes you just have to tip your cap.
This to center field. Harris has a beat on it. Hauls it in for the out.
Now batter.
And now it's Frankie Lindor. Singy, you can't ask for anything more. This guy checks all the boxes offensively.
He is the ultimate professional, and it doesn't just start at game time. It starts in the afternoon, the way he prepares and gets ready for the ball game. I tell you what, his teammates feed off of the leadership that he shows on and off the field.
Clearly seeing the ball very well in this one. Just kept it simple. Played Pepper with the middle of the infield and took it back where it came from, and there's just no one there to knock it down.
Two outs, runner at first. Key Brian Hayes up now for the Mets. So when you talk about elite defensive third baseman, this guy's at the top of the list.
Stud. When you look at players like this, you play that hot corner, got to be pretty courageous over there with the way balls come off the bat. That's the kind of guy that every year you expect to be in the All-Star game and have a gold glove, if not a platinum glove.
Lindor the move. Pitch outside. He's safe, and he's safe.
I'm sure that still raised a couple of eyebrows because of this big lead, but I think it's more respect for their opponent, knowing that they've got to continue to add on if they're going to win this game. Don't take it as an offense. Take it as a sign of respect.
Second with two down. That's out to center field. That is the inning. Mets leave one, but they're on top by a count of 6-0. Back here at Citi Field. So here's Murphy now.
Sean.
So what are the skills you look for that make a really good defensive third baseman that elite?
Well, Boog, one of the things I think about immediately are just the feet. Does he have good feet? Is he able to quick
swing? And this one's blasted. It's got a chance. Grabs it right up against the wall.
That's a really nice job right there. Great awareness making the catch up against the wall. You see the perfect technique, feeling for the wall with the bare hand while keeping his eyes on the baseball as it's coming down, his glove in a good position to make the catch. That's exactly how you do it.
Finds its way through base hit. So the one out hit turns the lineup over. Wide throw, and it gets away. And he'll reach second with one away.
Well, that's just an unacceptable error right there. Just kind of lackadaisical in getting it back into the infield, and there's really no excuse for that. Turned a simple single into a runner in scoring position now.
And now the center fielder, Michael Harris. Pitches in there. That's strike one. The ground could be extra bases coming home, and that rolls into the corner.
Well done, drives in the run. He smashed that ball the other way and kept it fair down the third baseline. Did an excellent job of just throwing the barrel at the ball, even though he was a little late on it. Could be a chance here for them to start clawing back into this ball game.
Man at second with one away. Here's Jared Kelnick, who's 0 for 2 with a pair of strikeouts. This ball's chopped on the ground. Steps on first for the out. And here is Ronald Acuna Jr. He's got the power, but great contact skills. One of the best contact hitters in the game. Just missed. Two outs and a runner at third, and we're in the top half of the sixth. Outside low, now 2-0.
He hasn't wanted to challenge it. Both of those pitches off the plate away. Don't expect anything down the heart of the plate. You may just have to be patient and take your walk here.
Now a high fly ball out to left center. Hauls it into Indiana. The Braves add one on the RBI double, and this is now a 6-1 ball game. You're watching the National League Division Series on the show. Ready to go for the last half of the inning. And stepping in for New York, DJ Stewart. Lopez, 6'1 righty, 225 pounds. And he was born in the Dominican Republic. Yeah, the right-hander back to work. That one to first. Oh, nice play. Nicely done for the out.
Look at the big guy getting down and dirty, robbing what probably would have been a double if it gets by him. Love to see that, because most times it's the shortstop or second baseman, but he wants to get in the mix a little bit as well.
And here's the catcher, Francisco Alvarez. And first offering is fouled off. Pitch, and now it's even up. Movement in the Atlanta bullpen. Aaron Bummer, the left-hander, up and throwing. Lee getting loose as well. some heat there at 98 miles an hour.
Man, there was no deviating from the fastball right there. He just kept coming after it. Here it is. Hit it if you can. And he just couldn't find a way to put it in play.
And first offering is fouled off. Right-hander kicks, deals. Swing and a foul back. That's out of play. Two outs. Cuts and misses. It's a strikeout. Nothing doing for the Mets. They still lead it, though, 6-1. We go to the top of the seventh. Now the Atlanta cleanup hitter, Matt Olson. Rasmussen back to work.
This pitcher's done a good job of disrupting the hitter's timing with a mix of pitches and changing speeds. You want to keep that front foot inconsistent for the batter. Their swings are hesitant, and that's exactly what you want on the mound.
And the right-hander deals. Swing and a foul straight back.
Well, timing is the key to great hitting, and right now that door is still locked. They haven't been able to figure out pitch sequences, and it's impacting them across the board.
And out number one on the grab.
Quick reactions down there at first, and those can be tougher than they look sometimes. There could be all kinds of weird spin or knuckling action on the baseball.
Riley in the box again, takes a strike.
It really looks like these hitters have been in between with their timing today. Good fastball, excellent slider, but they've not been able to commit to one velocity and stay there.
And he handles it himself for the out. Two outs, base is empty. Now in for the Braves, Ozzie Albies. Bounced up the middle. On to first, and Albies is retired. And it's a 1-2-3 inning. Braves go down quickly here. They trail it 6-1. New pitcher for the Braves, Aaron Bummer.
Well, they need someone to stop the bleed and keep the score right where it is. Seems like a tough task today with the way this lineup is swinging it.
Stepping in for New York, Lane Thomas. He's a guy, Chris, whose highlights include some of the best throws from the outfield that you will ever see. Definitely one of the best arms of the sport. And a pinch. Swing and a miss.
Yeah, the infielders and the catcher can never give up on a play, because if this guy thinks he has a chance, he's going to throw it from the warning track if he has to.
Bummer deals. Oh, that got away from him. And he's going to reach on a hit-by-pitch to lead off the inning.
Well, they went after him right there with one of his best pitches. I'm really surprised that one got away from him.
Brandon Nimmo up now for the Mets. The kick and the pitch. Runner goes. That's in for a strike. Throw there. Safe. Close, but StatCast shows us why he so often seems to be on the safe side of these steal attempts, Chris.
Yeah, you see that plus speed. And bit of it to swipe that bag. Such a threat on the bases.
And here it comes. And a foul ball. Runner in scoring position. Nobody out. Here in the late stages of game two. On the ground, right side. And that one handled. Sends it to first. And one away in the bottom of the seventh.
Now back. The first baseman, Yandy.
Next is the cleanup hitter for the Mets, Yandy Diaz. He's already homered here in this one. And that's outside. And that's ball one.
One ball, no strike.
On the ground to the left, Riley. There for the out. Runner scores from third. Digging in, Jorge Soler.
With this kind of lead, he can swing freely, try to hit the ball out of the park, do what he loves to do.
Ground ball, Austin Riley. Slings it across. That ends the frame. So they scratch across a run on no hits, no errors, and no one left on. We look ahead to inning number 8. It's the Mets 7 and the Braves 1. We go to the 8th, and now it's the Braves DH, Adam Duvall. The pitch. And foul ball. The 0-1. Headed down the line. Nimmo ranging after it. Tries to make the play, but it's foul. Up and in. And a count 1-2. Swing and a miss. The velocity blasted it right past him.
Really love the pitch sequence right there. I'm telling you what, pitcher and catcher on the same page right now.
And now here is Sean Murphy, known for his rocket arm behind the plate. And that's outside.
I can't play around with him here. It's a 6-run lead at this point. Got to attack hitters, even if you give up a solo shot.
Thomas makes the play, and it's 2 away. Two outs, base is empty. Here's Orlando Arcia. Swings through that one. 0-1. They tried to get him to chase on a slider down and away. Two down, nobody on. And we're in the top of the 8th. That misses the zone. 2-2. And another ball. Michael Harris on deck for Atlanta. And he deals. On the ground to third. Hayes. Sends it across to first. Third out, and that ends the frame. This one pretty well decided at this point. Home half of inning number 8 straight ahead. It's the Mets 7 and the Braves 1. Penn Murphy on the pitch here.
And with the big deficit on the scoreboard, he almost has to just put that out of his mind. Every outing matters for relievers and their numbers, but I think it's tough to get up for this type of appearance the same way you would for one in a close game.
Francisco Lindor comes up to the plate. 3-for-3 with 3 singles. The pitch. At the belt and fires. This one popped up. Arcia settles under it and makes the catch. And there's one down.
Good hard fastball up in the zone right there. They look really good coming in, but it's so hard to get on top of as a hitter.
Now batting Key Brian Hayes. 0-for-3 with 2 flyouts and a ground out. And a swing and a miss.
Oh, that's that slope right there. He threw it extremely well. And talk about just a ton of breaks. So tough to get that barrel to.
Kicks and fires. Swings through that one out in front that time.
Well, he's been aggressive right out of the box, and a smart pitcher is going to play off of that, especially when you get to 2 strikes.
Struck him out swinging. Had him way out front of the slurve. Now it's DJ Stewart. 0-for-3 with 2 ground outs and a strikeout. swing and a miss. Strike one.
This guy's sink has so much drop in it. It's almost like a split finger fastball. Instead of just weak contact and balls on the ground, he gets swings and misses.
And a swing and a miss.
This guy's pounding the zone. Hitters don't have time to think in between pitches.
Swings through that, and it's a strikeout. And the Mets go 1-2-3. Three up, three down for him there. Game two heads to the ninth inning. It's the Mets 7 and the Braves 1. And welcome back to the ballpark. All set for the start of the inning. Here's the center fielder, Michael Harris. The pitch. And immediately pumps in a strike to the left-handed hitter.
One strike.
And down on strikes. Picks up strikeout number 7. Jared Kelner, the next to hit. 0-for-3 with 2 strikeouts and a ground out. And that's in there at the knees. Base is empty, one away. Here in the top of the ninth. Strike 2.
And he is just dialed in right now. Every pitch thrown with so much conviction.
That one missed.
Two balls.
Got him swinging.
Fast with 1, 2, and 3 to start this inning, but no trouble so far. I'm sure he'd love to strike out the side here. Make a little statement, but you got to be composed in this spot. Focus on getting this next guy. You got 2 good outs. Want to get the 3rd one and avoid the middle of that lineup coming up with a base runner. Could become dangerous.
And the pitch on the ground, and this should do it. Lindor on the first, fair game, and the Mets get it done at home, taking games 1 and 2 of the series.
This is what you call taking care of business. When you've got home field advantage and you win the first 2 games of the series, that's what you come to the ballpark to do. They've worked hard to get to this point. Now they're in the driver's seat. We'll see how they do once the series continues. But so far, they've set the tone.
So Singy, as the numbers show, a great performance on the mound in this one.
Absolutely, and that really set the tone from the beginning. A fantastic effort.
And a 7-1 finish in this one. For Chris Singleton and our entire outstanding crew here at MLB The Show, I'm John Ciampi. Thanks for joining us.